Thank you. sound of T-Sucks and Prophetic Steps on Plastic City. That's a brand new 12-inch. And before that, Underworld and Pearl's Girl on Junior Boy's Own. It's Colin Favour on Kiss. Many thanks to Steve Jackson. Steve, be back with you at 10 in the morning here on Kiss. And don't forget another rundown of the Kiss House Music Chart, same time next Tuesday. In around half an hour or so, I'm going to be talking to my very special guest tonight, Carrie Leckerbusch, otherwise known as Fred, among others. So that's going to be coming up in around 30 minutes' time. Meanwhile, lots of brand new tracks to play you. Keep it locked. This is Carbon Unit and Chlorine on Chemical Honey Records.
We'll be right back.
Released for Carbon Unit on Chemical Honey Records, that's Chlorine. And another wicked track on the other side. Well worth checking out. Maybe I'll try and play that next week. Deep Space in May is going to feature a Superstition record label party. And among those appearing is going to be Afi Yusuf appearing live. And here's a track from his forthcoming double EP on Superstition Records. This is number 6.
Right. Volume 2. The original home of Robert Miles. Featuring the hit single, Children. Plus tracks from Union Jack, Art of Trance, Poltergeist and more. Platypus Records Volume 2. The quality UK trance compilation. Out now on CD and double vinyl.
How much do you really know about ecstasy? Or how much do you think you know?
They're only just beginning to find out about the damage it does.
True.
It makes you lose water in, like, your vertebrae, and that's where you get back pains.
False.
It contains a hormone.
False.
It does affect your period. It affects the way your whole body system, the whole clock works.
True.
And I was really sure of what it can actually do to your body and what the long-term effects are.
True.
Drink enough water to make sure you don't get dehydrated. Just don't drink more than, like, you know, a pint or so an hour.
True, when you're dancing. And you should also keep your salt levels up. If you want to know more facts and less fiction, or you'd like a talk, call the National Drugs Helpline free and in confidence on 0800 77 6600. Your call won't show on the bill. Ecstasy. Know the score.
Hey, our kids, are you a nosy neighbour? Fancy checking out number 5's three-piece suite or filling the length of number 8's shag pile? Then pop round for a cup of sugar this evening. Will your neighbours be out? Will the hackers like? That Paramount channel is showing Due South, Soap, Taxi and Frasier on the telly between 8 and 10.30pm weekdays. So don't forget, plan ahead like. Tell your neighbours that the Paramount channel is on satellite and cable. Hey, excuse me, love, could I borrow some sugar?
This Saturday, the Satellite Hub sees the opening of two new rooms, plus Games Room featuring Sega and virtual reality machines. Special guests all the way from New York City helping us celebrate the opening of David Camacho and performing live the best of his old and new, we welcome back Mr. Michael Watford, alongside residents Seamus and Omar. Whilst in Galactic Heights, joining Craig are guests Dave Lambert, Andy Morris and Dave Stewart. Doors open 10 till 6, it takes before 11, more after. The Satellite Club is a Mooncat production every Saturday at the Coliseum Vauxhall.
This is Juan Atkins with the voice transmission from Deep Space Central. You're listening to Colin Favor on KISS 100 FM, London.
another track from the forthcoming new single from The Advent. That track's called Jammin', and we'll be playing more from that over the next couple of weeks or so. Roland Kasper, new music from him. This is Punch Drunk, forthcoming on Essence Records from Germany. Carrie Leckerbusch coming up very soon.
Taking speed can feel good, but as you speed up, so does your heart rate. And even if you're young and healthy, there's a dangerous strain on your heart. Even if this doesn't happen, you could still end up suffering from tiredness, depression, mental illness, and physical exhaustion. If you'd like more information or a talk, call the National Drugs Helpline free and in confidence on 0800 7766 00. Your call won't show on the bill. Speed. Know the score.
Calling all you door-to-door salesmen out there. Seeing more front doors than a DIY superstore assistant? Fed up that the only replies you ever get are from the Rottweiler? Then ring those doorbells this evening. Customers will definitely be in, because that Paramount channel is showing Due South, Soap, Taxi and Frasier between 8 and 10:30 p.m. weekdays. Better make sure the Cavalier can hold enough stock, because the Paramount channel is on satellite and cable. You won't see those dusters. The dust.
Look, keep your head down.
Inject it with a poison.
Or wear a visor.
I'm a fire starter.
A gun shield. Because this one's going right in your face. Look out for techno heads. Techno heads. With the new number one from the Prodigy. Techno heads. There's a crash test dummy on the front. It should be avoided. Techno heads on Telstar.
You're a fire starter.
Body mandate.
This is Colin Favor on Kiss 100. My very special guest on the show tonight is Carrie Leckerbusch, also known as Fred, Brain Cell, Vector, Rototype, to name just a few as many aliases. Hi, Carrie.
Hi.
Welcome to England.
Thank you very much, Colin.
When did you first get into actually listening to dance music?
I think my first experience to dance music was, I'd say, in the early 80s, because
it must have been the electro.
Yeah, I think that's the first term that I used to combine dance music and, yeah, I mean, dance music.
Would you say that was a kind of major inspiration for your music?
Yeah, definitely also was a major inspiration, together with Kraftwerk and all kinds of electro. I mean, I bought all the electro compilations on African Bambaataa and Tommy Boy, and so that's a major influence.
I must say, you're actually based in Stockholm, is it?
Yes,
in
Stockholm.
And tell me about your first recording. How did that come about, and when did you first actually start making music?
I mean, I started to collect records all the way from the beginning, when Kraftwerk, like in the early 80s, when I found my first Kraftwerk records, and then the electro records, and all the way up to house and stuff. I think it's like a process that started for me very slow, because already then we was cutting our own tapes and then just mixing. And I mean, I remember my friend, he had like a toy that we rebuilt into a little synthesizer that made, you know, Space Invaders sounds.
Oh, yeah.
And we made a track. It sounds horrible, but we made a track. Anyway, I mean, that's the only thing we could do, because we couldn't afford synthesizers. I remember I was going into music shops and looking at drum machines and just like, wow, this. And the guy worked there, he showed it how it worked for us, and we was just like, wow, this is it. So about the first thing I got involved in was, I think, doing some programming for like electro, the guy that made hip-hop and electro music, and I was in and did some edits and just basically threw in some ideas.
We'll be right back.
Leckerbush, my special guest tonight. That's the Jazz Maze, which appeared on first on the Mayday compilation. It's now coming out on Hybrid number 24. How did you find playing at Mayday? Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I think I thought it was going to be a lot different, but it was quite good. The floor that I played on, all the DJs were good. The live acts were excellent. And
that was the second room there?
Yeah, it was like the it was not as big as the main hall where all the commercial acts were at, but it was very good. The light, the sound, the crowd, I think it was good.
Hybrid is your own label. When did that actually begin?
It began long time ago, even before I started my labels. I was doing a lot of paintings and different things, and it was something I called the hybrid style, because I mixed two things, and when you do that, it's called a hybrid. Mm-hmm. I started to make a lot of tracks, and I sent them out to labels, because in Sweden there were not many labels around. And nobody wanted it, and saying it's this is too difficult, the music is too difficult, people not going to buy this. And I think I thought of them like not seeing clear visions of the future. So that was one basic idea behind Hybrid, because I had these many tracks, nobody wanted them. So I put them out on Hybrid. And that's why a lot of the tracks on Hybrid are old tracks, but I think they're like timeless in my ears.
Absolutely. And you actually linked up with Planet Rhythm with Glenn. How did you meet Glenn?
Actually, Glenn called me because he was living in south of Sweden with his Swedish girlfriend, and he called me and said, okay, my name is Glenn, and I have a record store here in south of Sweden. And I thought, you know, it's time for a good label here in Sweden, because there are no good labels around. Mm-hmm. And I mean, he likes most the classic techno tunes, so he said, I'm going to start this techno label, and you know, you want to send me maybe two tracks? And of course, I got a guy here that has two tracks for me, and we can make a split EP. So I sent him two tracks, and he got so overwhelmed, and he said like, oh, I like these tracks so much that do maybe have two more. So I made two more and sent them to him, and the first Planet Rhythm came out together with the second one, and it got just incredible buzz, and it was just selling. It just was raging, and we did like only 1,300 copies, but for us it was just like incredible. We could have done much more, but we wanted to keep a low profile. Mm-hmm. And just, you know, start small and let it just slowly grow to something really sturdy, something solid.
How many copies do you actually press up of each hybrid release?
I press up 2,000 and I keep 100 for myself and my friends. So I sell about 1,900. It depends. Sometimes, you know, the pressing plant, they get something wrong, so they send me 1,600. So I'm a bit short. But I limited 2,000, I would say, every record.
Next track we're going to hear is Drum and Noise Style. Tell me about this one.
It's actually like a good explanation of my style. It swings very good, and I think it's a good party track, this one, if you want to lift the crowd. And it's minimal, and the drums are very carefully programmed, and weird noises. I think this pretty sums up my personality.
Okay, this is Carrie Leckerbush and Drum and Noise Style, Hybrid number 5.
Church. Footlocker. Hi, welcome to Foot Locker.
New Air Max running shirt, size 42.
Find everything you need.
Taxi.
Hey!
The new Air Max running shoes from Nike are in Foot Locker, the Wick Gift Centre, Croydon.
Manhole.
How much do you really know about speed? Or how much do you think you know?
You know, you can get really, like, addicted to it.
True.
It completely, messes around with your metabolism.
True.
Your teeth fall out.
False.
There's no really, great risks.
False.
You can feel aggressive and angst-ridden.
True.
Just makes you rush around, talk loads, gives you a jittery jaw, and go out talk absolute rubbish for ages to anyone.
True.
It strips the calcium in your body.
False. But it can leave you feeling exhausted, hungry and depressed. If you want to know more facts and less fiction, or you'd like a talk, call the National Drugs Helpline free and in confidence on 0800 77 66 00. Your call won't show on the bill. Speed. Know the score.
La plus grande aventure musicale du siècle a commencé. La techno. Accompagnez Carl Cox dans son voyage initiatique. Vous en reviendrez encore plus fort. Carl Cox, élu DJ de l'année.
Carl Cox Fact, double CD, available now from HMV at a special price of $11.99. Carl Cox Fact, out now on React.
The Slinky Sisters this Friday present another night of fun and frolics with our two Slinky residents, Rod Blake and Scott Mack, and our very special guest, Ricky Stone. Slinky takes place at Legends, 29 Old Burlington Street, and runs from 10 till 5. The price on the door is £7 before 11.30, £10 thereafter, and £5 after 3 a.m. So this Friday, come down and join the Slinky Sisters, Scott Mack, Rod Blake and Ricky Stone at Legends, 29 Old Burlington Street, West 1. Let's turn it up.
This is Colin Favour on Kiss FM. My very special guest tonight, Carrie Lickerbush from Sweden. You have, apart from Hybrid, you have some other labels.
Yes.
Trainspotters
Nightmare. Trainspotters Nightmare.
It's why do you call it that?
It's a side division for Hybrid because my love to Chicago inspired tracks is very big. It's always been since the early stuff and like. In the end of like 1986, I bought my first like Chicago Tracks record, and I was so inspired by this. So next to Hybrid, I have something called Trainspotters Nightmare, where I put out more minimal track styled house music, instrumental, and I got actually people from Chicago doing music for these labels.
Oh, really?
By Gene Hunt, for example, from
yeah.
And I have together with Glenn a label that is called Audio Pollution, where we want to put out the tracks that are more mellow, more listening, jazzy, jungle, just anything that is, you know, you want to listen to at home.
Next track we're going to listen to is actually one of my favorite tracks of yours, Fred Free, Clap Your Hands. Tell me about this.
Thank you, Colin. I like that track really myself. It started out with a sample. Clap Your Hands Everybody, and I've used it before in an old track which nobody wanted, of course, and so I had to do this again, and I made it more rougher for the Tim Taylor's Missile label, and I just put in the sample again, and I thought, let's just make just a major clap sound and just throw in this sample and make the drums really rough, and I made this track actually very, very fast.
Mm-hmm.
It happened in eight hours or so with the recording and everything. But I really, really like this track.
Okay, this is Clap Your Hands.
Thank you.
Fred Free, Clap Your Hands, which came out on Missile Records. How did you meet up with Tim Taylor?
Quite a long story, I think.
Well, a short version.
Yeah, this is the short version. Okay, I was working, doing some records for Experimental Records in New York.
For Damon?
Yeah, at the time when Damon had the label, and he was running the label. And he liked my music, and so I made him actually two double packs. And it ended up being released one double pack called Shape Changer Crystal Dreams Volume 1 and a record called Magenta EP. And after that, of course, Tim and Damon have worked together during that time. So I sent some new tracks to Damon, and when Tim was there, and he called me up and said, like, hey, this, maybe I can do this for my new project in England, which is going to be called Missile. So that's when the first Fred on Missile came out. Yeah. The Fred 2.
Going back to your DJ career, have you you spent quite a lot of time traveling around Europe and
actually seen most of Europe now, and
you played outside Europe at all? America?
I've been in the States and I played there, but I wouldn't really say it was not a booked date. I just was there visiting a friend in California and we played together at the party. I think it was just a fun thing to do.
I always hate this question when people ask me, but do you have a favorite club anywhere?
Oh yeah, I don't mind that question actually. I have many favorite clubs. I think I have a couple in each country now.
I mean, do you find the crowds very different in each country you play? Or?
Very, very different, yeah. I think. Very different.
So where is your number one place?
I would say if I can drop more than one, I would say definitely in Spain there's a club called Blau, outside Barcelona. Very good. North of England, Orbit. Very good. And your club, Deep Space, was very good.
Very nice of you to say that.
And I have a favorite club in Sweden, of course, also, which is called Docklands, which is not going on right now, but maybe at the end of summer it's going to open again.
Apart from your own music, you do quite a lot of remixes now as well. How do you set about working on somebody else's track?
I mean, I think it starts... I mean, you get the sounds, what they send you on that, and you start listening to the... I always start to listening to the original, usually. And try to find something that I like, because sometimes there's a particular sequence in the track that I really like, but I like to take out sequences like a hi-hat program or something just that's in the background, and I just reshape it into something else. And I tend to use very little of the actually sounds that they send me. I like to restructure always.
They end up sounding like a Carrie Leckerbush track.
Yeah, I guess so. But that's really the point of remix now,
of course.
To make something new. I mean, if you just do the same thing but with like a, I don't know, with a different tempo or just... that's a bit boring. I think we should do what I call a total re-architecture.
Do you actually get many offers from remixes? I mean, people send you tapes?
No, I don't think so much. In the past, nearly nothing, I would say. Mm. That's why I haven't done so many remixing. But now there's quite a lot, actually.
You get many demo tracks sent to
quite a lot, actually, from all over the world, from Japan and Australia and Germany.
You're always looking for interesting stuff to release?
Definitely.
Yeah. There was one question that somebody asked me to ask you. Why Fred? Why the name Fred?
Yeah, it's a Swedish word. It means peace in Swedish. And you pronounce it Fred.
Fred.
Yes.
Okay, next track we're going to hear is Crushed Insect, Put Me On Your Sandwich, which is absolutely brilliant title. this is Hybrid 4. Tell me about this track.
Yeah, it's actually a re-architecture, what I call, of the original Put Me On Your Sandwich, which came out on vinyl, the Hybrid number 4. And this is like it's been put on a compilation. And all the tracks that I put on the Hybrid compilation, I remixed, so to speak. So this is like the... even more abstract a mix of this very abstract house track.
Put Me On Your Sandwich. crushed insect put me on your sandwich by Carrie Leckerbush. Does Hybrid have an internet site as yet?
Actually, yes. They are working on one. You can already look at it. It's under P-Rhythm. But if you go into P-Rhythm, you will find the Hybrid page there also. And I have information about all releases and all what I call sound architects, like all the people who do music. And it's really, the layout is really funny. It's all this agent story, and everybody has an agent code, like I'm the agent commander, and it's quite funny, actually.
So people can get in touch with you through email as well?
Yeah, the email address is P-Rhythm, and then you have this A in a circle, I don't know what to call it, and then it's algonet.se. SE is for Sweden.
Great. You've already done some tracks with other people. Are there any other artists you'd really like to work with?
Well, everybody has their favorite artists, and records, but I would like to...
Which other artists do you actually really admire or like?
There are quite many, but I would like to do something with... I know it's never going to happen, but for example, James Pennington, The Suburban Night, I would like to do something because I really, really feel strongly for his tracks. And I mean, I had the opportunity now to do music with DJ Skull, Ron Manny, which is now a good friend of mine. And
yeah, I love his stuff.
Also Gene Hunt, and just to name a few. I would like to do something else with maybe even Mad Mike or something like that. It would be very interesting, I think. But it's not ever going to happen. We actually talked about letting Mad Mike do a remix for me. But I don't know.
Next track we're going to hear is actually coming out on Missile. It's not released yet. It's a remix of The House of God, which was recorded by DHS many years ago. So when's this going to be released?
I think it's going to be released very soon. Tim is going to put out a double pack on Missile with remixes from me, Paul Johnson, Thomas B. Heckman, and The Surgeon.
Okay.
Everybody has their own version of this track.
Brilliant. This is The House of God. FM, my special guest tonight, Carrie Leckerbush. Plans for the future, are there going to be more labels? Or?
I don't think there's going to be more labels because I got pretty much everything. I can release all different styles that I make.
Have you actually had any offers from major companies?
No, nothing at all. I would say no directly, because I want to have total control over my future. And I mean, in my future, I can even see pressing my own records, doing own distribution maybe, and own mastering everything. And just like submerge to Intellinet, you know. That's like the thing to do, I think.
There's also a hybrid art catalogue. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I'm thinking of releasing it together with the record, putting a catalogue for free in each release. Maybe my LP that is coming on hybrid this summer. And I'm gonna have an art gallery with photos of my paintings and just interviews with hybrid producers, just funny things, serious things, nice layouts, and just, you know, the vision side that I really like a lot, and I've been working with it for a long time also.
Mm-hmm. So when you're not in the studio, you relax with your art?
Yeah, I would say so. If I'm not in the studio, I mean, of course, with friends, or I'm painting or just doing something on the computer, maybe. Or...
Finally, live performance. Have you ever done any?
Yes, I've done quite a few live performances, mostly in Sweden, of course, and once in Finland. I want to do it in the future again. I can't do it right now because I can't drag my studio around. Always something breaks down, but I'm gonna maybe after the summer try to get a piece of equipment so I can make it live. Because it would be fun to try to do so.
Well, we definitely look forward to you playing live in London sometime. That would be great. Okay, Kerry, thanks very much for taking time to talk to us, and keep on turning out the good music.
Thank you very much, Colin.
Yeah, many thanks once again to Carrie Leckerbush for coming in and doing the rap. Regis and Itel on Downwards Records from Birmingham. And before the break, Freaks of Science on a brand new label from the Isle of Wight, Precise Daily Rhythm. Many thanks to Andrew Jones for that one. This Friday, Growth with DJ Cy Beg, Subhead, the Von Trapp Family, Mark Dow, and a live PA from Darkstar from Abstract Dance Records. That's Growth. Doors open at 10, goes on till 6 in the morning. And it's at the Foyer, Bagley's Warehouse, Acorn Studios, King's Cross. That's in the freight depot, by the way, York Way, N1. £6 with a flyer, £8 on the door. And just in case we didn't need another club on a Friday, we have one. Absolute. With CJ Boland, Dave Angel, Christian Vogel, Eric Powell, Mark Williams, Craig Thomas, Hazy, Paul Thomas, and Barry Ashworth. Takes place at the New Coliseum, 19 Elms Lane, Vauxhall, London, SW8. Admission £7 before 11, £10 until 3, and £5 after. Absolute. It's the first one this Friday. And there's another one here. Friday the 12th of April. Euphoria at the Arts Centre, St Mary's Church, Colchester. From 8 p.m. till late. Trance, Hard House and Techno with Fabi Parry, Andy Baker, Andy Bird, Jack and Shock.